players in this conference.
Yeah, it's one of our best wins of the year was beating Harding by 1 point or those free throws that we made at the end. Harding beat us last year. We split with them. If we win, it'll be a really good win. That big that they have, I'm trying to make sure I don't say something and I'm missing someone, but he's first team all league for sure, and he's the best big, one of the best bigs in the region, in the conference. And so thank goodness we have another live body in Nigel. Not that Nigel's tall, but we have another guy that we can throw on him. And so we're going to try everything we can to try to come out of here with a one-point win.
Those are the pregame thoughts from OBU head mid-basketball coach Jason Akers. We're moments away from tip-off today in game number two between Harding and Oklahoma Baptist. We talk about Taylor Curry. He's averaging 23.8 points per ball game, nearly a double-double at 9.6 rebounds. He had 31 points in the loss on Thursday night at Southern Nazarene, had a double-double against OBU in the near-Harding win in Searcy back in January, 22 points, 13 rebounds. They only have one double-figure scorer, that is Taylor Curry, but Keelan McBride, a very promising redshirt freshman guard, 5'9 of Jonesboro, Arkansas, had 16 points and 2 assists. He also pulled down 1 rebound, and he missed a shot at the buzzer that would have at least sent the game into overtime, maybe even beaten Oklahoma Baptist to start that 2-game Arkansas road trip. Harding beat out score by almost 7 points a ball game. They average 72.5. They give up 79.3. They shoot well for the floor, 46%, but allow 48% field goal shooting. OBU this year led by Paul King, 16.5 point per game average. Paul had one of those games, big shots, big free throws down the stretch. 22 points, 7 rebounds, 4 assists, 3 steals in Searcy in OBU's win on January the 12th, 64-62. DJ Freeman also averaging double figures among the active players, 12.7 and 6.8 rebounds per ball game. An update, Ricky Brown injured his ankle in today's morning workout, and so he is going to give it a go. He's in the starting lineup, so we'll have to see how much, if any, that affects Ricky and how much he can go, if at all, for very long here today. Jason Aker did something he told me today he's never done in his coaching career. He gave the team off yesterday. They had a nice dinner at his house. They watched film, came back, and went through the shoot-around today. And I told him I thought this team looked tired on Thursday night. And, you know, he's trying to find the right mix of playing his main guys and also utilizing his bench.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that, that you've got to keep a mental, fresh outlook on the season, because every team's naturally going to be tired by the time February comes around. And just by having that day off and having the stress-free where the coach can be your friend, because the coach can't be your friend all the time. He's going to be on you a lot to make you a better player. But just to let the players rest their minds, maybe they'll have a little spunk today.
All right, that's our pregame show. Stay tuned. It's Harding and Oklahoma Baptist next from the Noble Complex at Shawnee of the Bison Sports Network and Classic Hits, KGFF. Our national anthem inside the Noble Complex on this Saturday afternoon. Final game of the two-game homestand with Arkansas Tech and Harding coming up momentarily. The Bisons and the Bison. Oklahoma Baptist 11-11, 8-8 in the conference. Harding has dropped 10 straight. They're 1-15 of the league. They can win on the road, though. Their only road victory was at Harding. That was, at Southeastern back on January the 7th. Here's the starting lineups. First of all, today for the visitors from Searcy, Arkansas, coached by Jeff Morgan at his 31st season, his 32nd overall. Jeff also doubles as the athletic director at Harding and oversees an 18-team sport department. Keelan McBride will start, a 5'9 redshirt freshman from Jonesboro, Arkansas, averaging 9 points and 1.7 rebounds. He had 16 points against Oklahoma Baptist in the first meeting. JT Smith will start, a 6'3 junior from Kinsett, Arkansas, averaging 4.7 points and 2.8 rebounds. Stetson Smithson making his 16th start, 17th appearance, a 6'7 junior from Bald Knob, Arkansas. He averages 8.9 points per ballgame and 5.6 rebounds. He played 33 minutes, only 2 points, but 10 rebounds against the Bison in Searcy. Ramiro Santiago will start, a 6'4 fifth-year senior out of Argentina. Ramiro Santiago averaging 8.6 points per ballgame and 2.3 rebounds. And the aforementioned Taylor Curry, a 6'1 junior transfer from Akron University, had 31 at Southern Nazarene, 22 against OBU in the first meeting, averages 23.8 per ballgame. Jeff Morgan, 452 wins, 410 losses at Harding. With his 1 year at West Texas A&M, he has 470 wins, and that ranks him third all-time among Arkansas basketball coaches. The starters tonight for Oklahoma Baptist, they are 6-6 and inexplicably 3-6 here at the Noble. Bradley Akile will make his 10th start of the year, a 6'7 junior transfer from Incarnate Word, averaging 4.8 points per ball game and 2.4 rebounds. Josh Udomo will start. He makes his third career D2 start, a 6'4 freshman from Victory Christian Academy in Tulsa. Udomo averaging 3.9 points, 2.3 rebounds a game. Nigel Wilcox will play in his 9th game this year, all starts. 6'6 junior transfer from Webster University by way of Alpharetta, Georgia. He averages 9.5 points, 4.5 rebounds, shoots 62.5% from the floor. Ricky Brown is gimpy, was injured in this morning's shoot-around. He is a 6'2 junior from Valdosta, Georgia, averaging 9.7 points and 3.3 rebounds. And Paul King is the 5th starter, a sophomore transfer out of Monroe, Louisiana, by way of Alcorn State, averaging 6.5 points, 3.2 rebounds. He was good, 22 points, big shots, big free throws down the stretch in the 2-point OBU victory at Harding. Bison come in averaging 73 points a game. They're 55 points against Arkansas Tech, a season low, on Thursday night, and it was tied for the third fewest points in a single game now in 5 years under Jason Aker. They scored 47 back in 2019 at Southern Arkansas, 49 at Southern Nazarene in 2021, and the other 55-point performance was in the South Central Regional a couple of years ago down at Lubbock, Texas, against Lubbock Christian in 2021. Jason Aker is 6-1 against Jeff Morgan head-to-head. He is 3-0 against the Harding Bisons here in Shawnee. And despite 6 losses this year at home, OBU is 48-14 here at the Noble under Jason Aker. Harding on the road, 1-9. They are 1-8 in conference play. They've lost 10 straight. Their only league win was a road win, we told you, at Southeastern down in Durant, a place that the Bison will visit in a couple of weeks to conclude a 2-week 4-game road odyssey. McBride, Smith, Smithson, Santiago, and Curry for Harding. Again, Akile, Udomo, Wilcox Brown, and Paul King, with Trey Green likely the first off the bench. And I think Trey just plays better coming off the bench, don't you?
Well, I don't know about that. I just like to have Trey Green on my team. So I think Trey is so versatile that it doesn't matter if he starts or if he comes off the bench, but you're exactly right. He gives you a big push when he comes off the bench.
Big, big push. Akile of the home, white, green, and gold. The jump center against Taylor Curry. Harding of the road, black and gold. Harding will go from right to left. Oklahoma Baptist left to right. And here we go. The Bison of the Bisons, part number two. This time it's Shawnee. And the ball volleyed around, and Nigel Wilcox picks it up in the left quadrant. Hands it off to Udomo, who starts at the point guard position. Baseline right is Brown, cutting back door Akile. Pump fakes, goes up and lays it in. A good start for Bradley, who has been struggling, and it's 2-0 Oklahoma Baptist.
Great call by Aker right out of the chute. Right there, Akili comes down off the curl underneath. Quick pass by Brown.
J.T. Smith with the basketball veers right. All over him is Josh Adubo. 2-0 Oklahoma Baptist. Santiago to Curry down low. Taylor banks his way in off balance. Throws it up, trying to buy the foul. Went to the floor. The shot hit the rim. Bound away. King has it. Speeds back the other way. Whips it to Ricky Brown. His first three. Spins out. No good. Nigel tips the rebound up. Udomo has it for the way in, and it's 4-0 OBU.
Boy, instantly. Coming out. This is just the second game for Wilcox. Huge tip for that extra shot.
19-07 to play in the first half from Shawnee. 4-0. OBU in a man-to-man defense. McBride drives left, kicks into the corner. Santiago's three is good. Ramiro Santiago averaging almost 9 a game, knocks down his 35th triple. Harding shoots 31% from beyond the arc and averages almost 7 makes a ball game. 4-3, the Bison advantage down to 1.
And that's where Santiago hits most of his shots from the corners, kind of the offense that Coach Morgan runs.
Brown from Akile returns it to Bradley out front. Now to King, swings it right side. Udomo with a left-handed dribble, gets around Curry. Sets Akile up for three in the left corner. That's short. Bradley off the side of the rim with the miss. To Paul King, turns to the three, accelerates right side. Now it's Brown who rattles the triple home. And Ricky Brown, who was really gimpy after the morning shoot-around, gets his first bucket. OBU's back up by 4.
How about the unselfishness of King? He has an open three, but even more open is Brown.
Keelan McBride dribbles left, leans, and gets King, floats it home. I'm telling you, I like this kid. Redshirt freshman guard, plenty of talent on this Harding team. 7-5, we play 2 minutes exactly here in the first period.
King looks like he jammed that left thumb again. He looked like he was grimacing in pain there for a little bit.
Paul tries to pass down low. Curry tips it away from Nigel Wilcox. Now King slides on the floor, falling on the floor, kicks it to Udomo, left wing. No good. Curry with a rebound. Knocked out of bounds by Nigel Wilcox. So Harding will get it with a chance to tie or take their first lead.
Okay, here's a chance for the Bison, you know, have a stop and get a couple buckets just to keep the road team from getting that momentum.
Harding was blown out at the Sawyer Center in Bethany on Thursday night, 90-62 against league-leading 17th-ranked Southern Nazarene. Bison will be there on Monday night. Ramiro Santiago doubled out front. Now they fall away. Cross court to the McBride. Left corner three, too strong. Rebound to Ricky Brown. Brown will bounce out of the backcourt, and here come the Bison left to right on radio dial. Paul King, a crossover dribble, gets deep against McBride, shoots as Curry tried to swat it from behind. The ball in the cylinders rattles out, but Wilcox is there for the tip-in. Nigel, 33 minutes, more than Jason wanted to play him on Thursday night. Didn't have a big stat night, but his presence was big.
Yeah, he tipped that in on the way down. That ball took an extra bounce.
Curry lays it up and rolls off no good from in front of the rim. He didn't miss many of those. He shoots 63% for the floor. Akile gets a bounce pass on the other end and lays it in. 11-5, Oklahoma Baptist. They've scored 4 straight.
Yeah, King's calling to come out. That was all Paul King going up the middle, around all the defense, and a perfect lead pass.
Santiago drives left over. Wilcox glides one in off the window. Ramiro with his second basket has 5. Softball has beaten Rockhurst today down at Midwestern State in Wichita Falls, 3-0 the final. King loses the handle briefly, now gets it back, works right over Wilcox screen, pulls up elbow right, jumpers off the front rim. Taylor Curry gathers the miss off the floor. 11-7 Oklahoma Baptist, 16-16 to play here before the break. Smithson with a rare touch here early offensively to Keelan McBride. McBride yo-yo dribbles out front, now it's Smithson, he'll back out, fires a three. That one is online but short. Smithson gets his own miss. Stetson drives underneath the basket and stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, King was calling to come out of the game. Looked like there's something wrong with his hand, that he's really in pain.
Caleb Riggs has seen his role and workload increase lately. Will come in along with Ethan Scott and Trey Green. Talk about a guy that has been taxed during this injury-ridden season. That's Trey Green. He's played all 5 positions on the floor. Heavy volume of minutes. Bison, about as healthy as they're going to get. Trey Dooms will not come back, nor will Caden Carter. In fact, when you factor all the injuries, OBU have had a complete roster only 3 times this year. Ethan Scott to Trey Green, right wing side. Now Legend Barrett out there, goes to work against Taylor Curry. To DJ Freeman, he pump fakes, pulls up right wing, jumper good. DJ coming off the bench for only the 3rd time, knocks down a jumper, and it's 13-7 OBU.
Yeah, those kind of jump shots, what OBU needs when they're in a scoring drought.
Curry around Barrett, has the shot off the window, spin off. Legend with a rebound to Ethan Scott. Here comes the freshman from Mustang. Pushes up ahead, right quarter three by Riggs, was short off the side of the rim. McBride has it for Harding to the Bisons. Counterattack down the middle of the floor is McBride.
Yeah, Curry rushed that last shot But that time,
rushes that one and buries it.
Yeah, McBride. He was from downtown. McBride could have had his own rebound if he followed it before on his other miss from three-point
land. 13-10. McBride has five already. He had 16 of the first meeting. Ethan Scott with it out high, right of a screen from Barrett. Now Ethan will put up his first three of the day. Bang! He knocks it down.
That's what I was talking about in the pregame. Something like that. He needs to stay out there, and he'll make a couple more.
Curry, a bounce pass, banks his way in against Barrett, who may have got a piece of that ball. The ball juggled, the rebound lost by Freeman. Curry takes it away. Taylor puts it on the floor and a foul, and that's going to go against DJ Freeman in his first. I have so much respect for Taylor Curry, the way he plays this game hard. There was an example right there, outworking the Bison for the basketball.
Yeah, against multiple white shirts as well. I also like how Legend Barrett took the hit from Taylor Curry, just knocked him out of the way, caused Curry to miss the first shot.
Timeout, 14:43 to play first half. OBU 16, Harding 10 of the Bison Network at KGFF. Okay. Sam Henderson will enter the lineup, the first substitution of the day for the Bisons. He is a 6'1 senior from Fort Worth, Texas, second time off the bench after 21 starts. Henderson averaging 6 points and 1.8 rebounds per ball game. Bison in a man-to-man. Nigel Wilcox is out there. He defends the entry pass out high to Stetson Smithson. He works right angle. Smithson falls to the floor. They're going to call Nigel for a foul. And he helps Stetson Smithson up, and Wilcox now has his first.
Yeah, it looked like Wilcox's knee might have went into Stetson's knee and caused him to buckle, but that foul wasn't called until he hit the floor.
16-10, Oklahoma Baptist. Their biggest lead on a couple of occasions has been six. Santiago will trigger it inbounds to Stetson Smithson, right corner, crosses over, drives to the goal. Wilcox unable to block the shot, and what a good move by Smithson to pay it off the window, his first bucket.
That move had to be perfect in order to get that shot off against Wilcox, who was all over him.
Lead down to four, 16-12. Green holds right wing in front of Jeff Morgan on the bench. Top of the key with it is Wilcox. Attacks against Curry. Throws a one-hander up and rattles it home. Yeah. Nigel with four.
This is something that Harding didn't see in Searcy, is a little Nigel Wilcox. So I think that's a big advantage for the Bison here tonight.
Henderson to McBride, guarded out front by a fellow freshman, Ethan Scott. Scott, though, is a true freshman. McBride on the hedge, guarded by Wilcox. Now Ethan picks him back up. They bounce it right low post for Smithson. Kicks it out to McBride for three. Got it. He has eight already. Santiago with five, and that is all 15 of theirs. Taylor Curry has still not scored, and the deficit down to three again.
Yeah, Ethan Scott went down inside to try to help, but that allowed that kickout pass for Keelan.
Green's pass on a screen and roll, deflected, intended for Freeman. Santiago has it. Romero bounces it right side. McBride drives deep. Now Green slides down to cut him off. It's Henderson top of the circle. Gambling for the steal that time was Riggs. Smithson gets near the basket, kicks it out. Santiago's three rolls off with a rebound to Ethan Scott. Scott quickly back the other way, spins into the right front court to Trey Green. Left side, Riggs. Riggs against the Harding defense. Looks like it's a 2-3 zone.
That was an uncovered look by Santiago. That was from the right wing. See, he usually hits his threes from the corner.
Riggs pump fakes. Good bounce pass to Freeman, who lays it in with the left hand.
Well, you get the good bounce pass, and then look how quick Freeman is. One bounce on the floor, double pump underneath the defensive arms off the board.
12:48 to play first half. Oklahoma Baptist 20, Harding 15 inside the Noble Complex. Men garnering a split today with a win here against Harding. Right side, it's Santiago with the basketball. The senior from Argentina veers left of the screen from Curry. Push passes to McBride, left corner. He works to the wing, now speeds back to the baseline. Cross courts it for Santiago, who will lift up a three over Green. He missed it, and Curry knocks the rebound away from Ethan Scott out of bounds. We like this start defensively for OBU against Curry. 2 rebounds, 8 minutes. He's 0-4 shooting. Nigel will go to the bench. Ricky Brown comes in. Freeman is back in. Riggs and Scott will have a seat. And Bradley Akile is the third player out there on the floor.
You know, Todd, one of the things I always think about with the Bison is rare this year losing a lot of home games. They're not putting that team away. Like, they could get up by double digits here just to take that confidence away from Harding.
Driving left, Green all the way to the goal, and he pushes it in, two-handed off the window. Trey with his first basket, and it's back to a 7-point lead. That's the biggest for OBU.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice move by Green.
Left front court with the basketball is Wyatt Gilbert, a sophomore from Mountain Home, Arkansas. This is a relatively young Harding team. The freshman guard, McBride, right quadrant, trying to get it to Curry down low and throws it out of bounds, and Taylor is disgusted. He is not happy with that turnover. Timeout, 11:54 to play first half, 22-15, Oklahoma Baptist on the Bison Sports Network and KGFF.
Okay, guys, we got to make this quick. I got a 7 o'clock curtain call at the opera.
You know you could just order online.
No. A gentleman always does things the old-fashioned way.
All right, well, I just put your order in, so.
Well, it didn't tell you what I ordered.
I got you an ultimate patty melt with a side of loaded fries and a Dr. Pepper.
That is what I ordered. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We spend way too much time together.
Mm-hmm. Now you can order your food and fried pies online at boomerangdiner.com.
OBU fans, do you want...
Bison already with 16 field goal attempts. They are hammering Harding, shooting 62.5% to 43%. Bison's not bad, though, at 6 of 14. OBU plus 4 in the glass, 9-5. Harding with almost a negative board and a half rebound average per ball game. The Bison a little more than 1 to the negative side of the glass. Paul King back out there out of the break. Angles right down to Trey Green, Freeman, Akile, and Brown. The other three up there with the floor. DJ floats left, wanted to posterize it, missed the dunk. Akile's follow is shot is short, but he's fouled. Well, he almost posterized Taylor Curry that time. Davis Morgan, the coach's son, picks up his first. So Akile will go to the foul line. He's 77%. Oklahoma Baptist was just 8 of 13 free throwing Thursday night here against Tech. And Akile misses the first free throw. Harding opponent shoots 71%. Harding themselves a good foul shooting team at 76. Second free throw is up, and it's good. And the 2-point win in Searcy, OBU was a perfect 8 of 8, so not a lot of opportunities on the road, but they paid them off, and now they lead by 7 or 8.
Here the Bison picking up right at half court, man-to-man, really hard. I like this intensity right here.
Very good intensity. Gilbert with it out high, looks for Curry. Left wing side to Morgan, whips it across the floor, McBride to the corner to Henderson. Henderson through the paint, a little runner, back rims it, rebound tipped twice, caroms right back to Wyatt Gilbert. It was first off of Curry and then to Bison. Wing right is Keelan McBride, and his bounce pass down low to foul. No shot, as that will go against Paul King. That's his first, and now 3 Bison have a foul as Paul will check out, and Udoma will come back in. Here comes Nigel Wilcox. Trey Green is going to go on the bench. Jason wants to try and limit some of these guys' minutes. Their effectiveness not as much so if they're playing 33, 35 minutes a game. Nigel is one of those guys that obviously can play. 33 in his first game since injury on Thursday night as DJ Freeman tips a lob pass out of bounds.
Well, you have so many good players that you can rotate them. The only thing that scares me is like somebody has a hot hand like Ricky Brown or Ethan Scott. Like Ethan Scott already hit that long three already and we hadn't seen him since.
Udomo on the inbounds pass or just before the pass called for a push his first. Fourth foul against Oklahoma Baptist. One of the board against Harding. And again, Gilbert baseline left to trigger it in. To Taylor Curry. He's gone more than 9 minutes without points at 31 at 7. Azarine moves left, puts up a right-handed shot, and he missed it. Well defended. Akile with the rebound. Outlets to Udoma.
Boy, Wilcox hit Curry low. He got away with one there.
DJ Freeman will put up a three left side. Splash! He got it. DJ coming off the bench for only the second time this year, has seven. That's his fifth made triple of the year in 15 tries.
And one's a three-pointer, and he's – there he goes again.
Freeman knocks the ball away from Gilbert and flushes it down to one handed on an acrobatic slam.
That's what I'm talking about, putting the team away. It's been quiet in here. You got the crowd back into it. You can put Harding away in the first half if you want.
28-15, Oklahoma Baptist. Harding starting to reel now. Gilbert between the circles to Davis Morgan. Morgan, his pass out front, knocked away and stolen by Wilcox for the two-handed hammer. Holy Toledo! Four, you are cleared for takeoff. Flight four. Timeout Harding to the 10-minute mark of the first half. Oklahoma Baptist 30, Harding 15 on the Bison Sports Network and Classic Hits, KGFM. Okay. Santiago drives baseline left to Henderson. O'Reilly for three. Missed it, but the intensity on defense is ferocious for OBU right now. 9.5 to play, and the Bison lead Harding by 15.
Yeah, closed off the baseline nicely. Forced Harding into a three-pointer.
Udomo to Akile. Hard drive to the rim. Got by with steps as he lays it in. Now let's see what they have. I think one official has a foul. The other has a travel. Yep. And that's what they're going to call. So it'll be a turnover for OBU. And that's only their second.
Yep. That's good officiating between Raymond Shipps and KC Bly. Because if the foul came after the travel, that's what they're talking about. They say, okay, the travel was first. So that's what we're going with.
9-12 to play first half. OBU up in dominating fashion by 15. McBride whips it left side. Santiago guarded by Ricky Brown. Doesn't seem to show any ill effects for that ankle injury. They'll go right side. Now floating to the paint, Henderson. Left side of Santiago. Bounces it to Sam. Seven to shoot. He races out front. Missed it. Curry's tipping traffic over three Bison is home.
Boy, Curry, I don't know if it's just his 6'11" height and reach or just the timing, because it looked like those white shirts are going to get it. Nice play by Curry.
He had missed his first five field goal attempts before his first basket, 30-17. Bison with 8.5 to play first half. Udomo into the body of Curry, and Taylor blocks the shot. Josh gets it back, picks his dribble up, lobs it out front to Brown. It's deflected by Henderson. Santiago has it to McBride, 3-on-3. And OBU quickly gets back, and Harding will settle with a half-court offense.
Did you see Curry? He jumped straight up in the air. Udomo ran into him, no call. These are some good officials
McBride,
here.
McBride, a deep three, back rims it. Okile down for the carom. That's his second rebound already.
Yeah, a lot of talent on the officiating crews on the men's side here in the GAC.
Make that the third rebound for Bradley, a team-high total. They bounce out of the baseline. Freeman, 17-footer, a little strong. Nigel tips the rebound up and back to DJ. Right side, open three. Bradley on the side, no good. Brown crashes for the rebound, and it's out of bounds.
Either Bradley Akili's legs are dead tired, or he just holding the ball too long, not shooting at the peak of his jump, because all three of his jump shots have been way underneath the rim.
Timeout on the floor, 7:53 to play in the first half. 30-17, Oklahoma Baptist to the Bison Sports Network at KGFF.
Want the chance to support OBU student athletes from the convenience of your own mobile device? Text hashtag BAA at OBU to the number 52014 to support BAA student athletes. Donations are fully tax-deductible, and every gift makes a difference in the OBU student-athlete's life. Again, text hashtag BAA at OBU to the number 52014. For more information, log on to obubison.com.
Shot clock had expired. They didn't get it reset. And so we'll have a stoppage as Casey Ely will come over to the scorer's table. We're going to look at it on the monitor to see how much time should be on the clock. 6:43 to play first half, 30-20 Oklahoma Baptist. Women fell earlier today by double digits. Disappointing game again for the Bison women, who have won just three of their last 11 but remain in fifth place in the Great American Conference standings with four in a row coming up away from Shawnee. And Jason pointed this out in the postgame show, and I think it's become true of the women as well. Now, part of that has to do with who you're playing, I understand. Jason said, I think we play better away from Shawnee this year for some reason. Well, we're about to figure that out, I guess, starting on Monday.
Well, they hadn't been doing what they did just a second ago. Now they're letting Harding creep in. You had those two steals and dunks, you know, Wilcox, Freeman. It just got it. The crowd's fired. Now it's dead in here again. And Harding's getting a little bit of confidence back. You can quench that with a bucket here and a couple of stops.
I don't know if you agreed with what I said that Jason said. I can tell you on paper they're better, a lot better. They play better record-wise than they have here at home.
Yeah, but there's still a lot of road games left, so I don't know if I agree with that. I have to look at that.
They record-wise are better than they are at home, I can tell you.
Because they played more home games.
They have three wins at home and eight on the road. Nigel Wilcox hands it off. King to Nigel on a screen and roll for the two-handed flush.
Well, if there was a choice, he'd want to play here.
Without a question, wouldn't we all? 32-20. 6:20 to play first half. J.T. Smith, guarded by Udomo. Between the rings is Manchuzic. And a foul called against Akile. That's his first.
OB foul number zero, Riley Akile. First personal, foul number six.
Keelan McBride will trigger it in bounce. He bounces it for J.T. Smith. Out high, now they cut Santiago to the basket for the layup.
Boy, King let Santiago get behind him just a step. He couldn't catch up. Santiago goes up high with the height advantage.
Harding's made three of their last four. They're up to 38% shooting. The lead back down to 10 for Oklahoma Baptist. Udomo to Wilcox out front, hands it off to Paul King. Gets set for three. It's short. Paul follows his own miss, drives, dishes to Akile for the slam. It's a slam party this afternoon here at the Noble. 34-22.
How valuable King going following his shot to get that, then the drop off for the dunk.
Already seven offensive rebounds for Oklahoma Baptist. Came to the paint. Smith lays it up, missed it. Udomo tips the rebound out, and Stetson Smithson then bangs into Nigel Wilcox, and a foul called against Smithson. Yep. That's his first.
Good call, Mr. Miller. That's exactly what the official had. Stetson didn't want that, but he did not have position. He went in front of Wilcox, who already was there.
. 34-22, 5:15 to play here in the first half. Todd Miller, Scott Wanish will come to you from the Sawyer Center on Monday night. Second of two rivalry night games between SNU and OBU. Freeman with his back to the basket. Smithson guards him. Left wing, it's Akile as he drives. It's poked away from behind, but a reach against J.T. Smith, who has his first. That's just the third against Harding with 5:13 to play here in the first half.
Yeah, OBU up by a dozen. Make another one of those runs, like I said, to try to quench that confidence.
Scott to trigger it inbound, left baseline for Freeman. Back to Ethan. Ethan in the left quadrant. Cross courts to King. 14 to shoot. To the goal he goes, and he's fouled. And J.T. Smith quickly picks up number two.
Well, see, Harding's overplaying their man-to-man defense, and they can't do that against the speed of the Bison, because Oklahoma Baptist, just as Paul King demonstrated, can ball fake and go to the rim with vigor.
Paul is 79% for the free throw line. He's been over 80 up until the last game. And he hits the first free throw. That's his first points of the afternoon as Gilbert comes in for Jeff Morgan's club. Here comes Trey Green, and looks like Udomo is going to come out of the lineup. Josh is listed at 6'4", Scott, but he plays like he's 6'7 or 6'8 with his vertical jumping ability.
Boy, and he's got speed on the court, too. He passes people off the dribble. Just an outstanding athlete.
Ethan Scott is out of the lineup. Nigel is back in as the second of two. King free throws is good. OBU 3 of 4 for the line. They build the lead back to 14 to one shy of their biggest, which was at 30-15. Under 5 to play first half, 36-22. Wyatt Gilbert hands it off, Stetson Smithson. They swing it through the top of the key. Santiago with it left side. Between the rings, McBride is poked away by King. Keelan gets it back, now 11 to shoot for Hardy. Keelan McBride looking for Stetson Smithson. He's covered up. Now in a give and go, they get it to McBride, who lays it in with the left hand. It was a good set by the Bisons, 36-24.
Once again, King was trailing that give and go play again. That time it was McBride that got the step on him.
4:17 to play first half, along with Scott Wattish and Bob Easley. I'm Todd Miller and Shawnee. King, a hard bounce pass to Freeman for the backdoor layup. Holy cow, did you see that?
Yeah, and King is playing like one-handed with that left hand all taped up, and he still can do it all.
38-24, 4 minutes to play first half. Out high, Keelan McBride. Bounce pass, right quadrant for Wyatt Gilbert. His pass knocked into the backcourt and out of bounds. And that saved the rim, perhaps, if Freeman is able to run that one down.
Oh, man.
Went out of bounds into the Harding bench.
Freeman is so much value. That's out in outside the perimeter where he anticipates that pass. Already went the other way with another dunk. About got another one.
Ethan Scott quickly went to the bench, comes back in. He guards McBride, who drives right, hangs and falls away. It knocks down a tough jumper. Keelan McBride already with a dozen of the 26 on the board for Harding. Taylor Curry, who is not out there, only has 2 points here in the first half on 1-of-6 shooting. Green attacks right baseline, goes back door, layup good, and Trey Green will get it in one.
Yeah, Green's looking at the size disadvantage at Harding when they put a guy on him. Because, like you said, Green plays all positions. It don't matter. When he gets somebody shorter than him, that's like lunchtime.
And here he comes. Curry will report back in on the backside of the break. Final media timeout at 3:36 to play of the half. Oklahoma Baptist.
Estate planning is a crucial step in protecting your family's future. With an estate plan, you can decide how to distribute your assets, make healthcare decisions, and support ministries after you pass away. It involves some pretty big decisions, but with guidance from Water's Edge, you can plan for your children's future, give to kingdom causes, and get expert help along the way. Build a solid foundation for your family. Start your estate plan today. Visit watersedgeservices.org.
Gilbert doing a lot of dribbling. Now takes Riggs off the dribble, throws it up, and the shot blocked by Wilcox, but Smithson's there to put the basket or put the ball through the hoop.
High IQ there by Stetson Smithson, being the trailer right behind the dribbler, so he's the first one, and he can anticipate that rebound.
How about Jason Akers' royal blue blazer today? It looks nice. I get to see a lot of it. King, the bounce pass out high, squares up, working against the redshirt freshman. Paul gets into the paint, scoops it up, no good. Bodies around the hoop, and it's Stetson Smithson that retrieves it. He dribbles out, gets it to Gilbert. Gilbert speeds ahead, left side of Santiago, bounce pass to Curry. Curry going to work and a foul. That's the eighth against OBU. So Taylor Curry's going to the free throw line, and Nigel Wilcox has his second. It's interesting that Freeman has three and Nigel has two, and hardly any of those have actually come guarding Taylor Curry today.
Well, that one did. And
it did.
I think Wilcox was trying to stop him, get to the hoop, and hit his arm off the dribble.
Free throw by Curry is up, and he rattles it home, so he'll get the back end of the bonus. Taylor Curry is 77% free throw shooter, right at what Harding is. They're actually just below. They average 14 tries, 10 makes per ball game to the Bisons. Second free throw, good. Nothing but that for Santiago or Curry, who has his fourth point. Those are the first free throws attempted by Harding this afternoon. Harding pressures in the backcourt. OBU beats it. Udomo to Paul King with a right hand across midcourt. Gilbert is out there with his face. Now he veers right. They roll Brown back to Paul King. He slides right, whips it across the floor. Udomo for three, bricked that one. Curry with a rebound. Taylor standing flat-footed, holds it above his head. Now his outlet pass deflected by Udomo. Smithson up ahead to Santiago. Right corner, he spins to the goal, feeds it to Curry. Layup good.
Boy, you wanted to be up double digits. A big run by Harding, only down five.
OBU has gone scoreless for the last 2:41. Harding now on a 9-0 run after trailing by 15. They've cut it down to 40-35. Caleb Riggs around the screen moves right to the top of the key. Udomo against the zone. Now to Ricky Brown, to Josh, to Riggs. Two dribbles, kicks it across the floor. Brown's three, good! Ricky Brown with his second three, and that was badly needed as OBU leads by eight.
Oh, it was badly needed. Big, 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 big shot by Brown.
Stops a drought in which OBU had missed their last four from three-point range and the last three for the floor. 43-35, the lead back to eight. Gilbert dancing to the Bison logo, middle of the floor. Difference of 3.5 on the shot and game clock late first half. Wyatt Gilbert hands it off on the wing. Ramiro Santiago with the basketball. Moves left, gets to the goal. Layup is short. He short-armed it. Rebound saved inbounds by Curry and a foul underneath.
Trey Green.
They've called it on Green, and that is his first.
Now, it wasn't a shooting foul. I think what Casey Ellie was saying is that Green blocked out Curry on the rebound and pushed him out of bounds.
Taylor Curry started to get more involved offensively, set for a while. The midway point of this first half, OBU built the lead to 15. Curry's back in, and he has the last four on the board for the Bisons. And he'll be there for the final 1-1 of the half, the ninth foul against Oklahoma Baptist. Free throw is up, and it's good. 4.1 seconds to play in the half. A lot of really good scorers, a lot of really good players in this league, but Taylor Curry is right at the top of the list of both. Second free throw is up, and he rattles it home. All of a sudden, he has a quiet eight, and the Bison want a timeout with 4 seconds to play. It's a 30-second timeout with Oklahoma Baptist leading by six.
I wonder if Aker can advance this ball up to half court, because you move that up with 4 seconds, have that happen. No, can't?
Can't do it in men's basketball. I wish they would change that rule.
You know, that's just confusing. I was used to it in the last game. You're right. That was the last game.
Maybe you can in the Little League games, you ref, but you can't
do that. Little League. I don't do the Little. Well, they're asking.
Oh, you ought to know by now. You're going to be poked at several times on this broadcast. Well, you handle it pretty well.
Yeah, well, you know, you have so many different sets of rules, like you say, for every level.
I wish the men's sport went at it like the women did.
Yeah, it makes it tough for anybody. So, like, if an official will officiate the women's game, and then the men's game, it's just different.
Green runs the baseline, throws it to half court. Paul King, 2 seconds, 1 second. King slips. They won't get the shot off. That's the way the half ends. Oklahoma Baptist 43, Harding University 37 at halftime from the Noble. We'll be back after these messages on the Bison Sports Network and Classic Hits, KGFF. Thank you. By the way, they closed an 11-3 run after it was 40-26.
Great American Conference basketball inside the Noble Complex. Harding University visiting here in Shawnee at halftime. Oklahoma Baptist in the nightcap. Lead Harding 43-37, but the Bison led 40-26. Late in the second half, closing out the half, Harding went on an 11-3 run to cut the deficit to 6 points. Biggest lead of the game for Harding, they have never led. Biggest lead of the game for the Bison is 15. That came at the 10:04 mark. Best scoring run for Harding, that was a 9-0 run. Right there, part of that 11-3 run. That was with 1:04 left before half. The Bison went on a 12-zip scoring run. That was with at that 10:04 mark. Leads never changed. Game's never been tied other than 0-0. And in time with the lead, the Bison lead over Harding 19 minutes and 47 seconds to zilch. Time with the lead. Points from turnovers, Bison 7, Harding 2. Points in the paint, Oklahoma Baptist 26, Harding 18. Second chance points, OBU 10, Harding 8. Fast break points, Bison 6-0 in that advantage. And then on the points off the bench, OBU 18-0 over Harding. Shooting in the first half for Harding, 14 of 32 from the field, 43.8%. 5 of 13 from downtown, 38.5%, a perfect 4 for 4 from the line. For Oklahoma Baptist, they're 18 of 33 from the field, 54.5%, 4 of 12 from three-point land, 3 of 5 from the charity stripe, just 60%. At halftime, Oklahoma Baptist leads Harding 43-37. This is Bison Basketball Classic Hits, KGFF. Thank you. 3 points. Stetson Smithson, 2 for 3 from the floor, misses only 3-point shot, 3 rebounds, 2 on the offensive end. He's got 4 points. Ramiro Santiago, 3 of 7 from the floor, 1 of 4 from 3-point land. He's got 7 points to round out the scoring for Harding. For Oklahoma Baptist, Bradley Akile got the start today, 3 of 6 from the field, missed both 3-point shots, 1 of 2 from the free throw line, 3 rebounds, 2 on the offensive end, 7 points. Nigel Wilcox, good to have him back, and an untarnished 4 for 4 from the floor. 3 rebounds, 2 on the offensive end, 8 points, but he's got 2 fouls. Another big man, DJ Freeman's got 3, so kind of iffy there for the Bison in the post. Joshua Udomo, 1 of 4 from the field, missed both 3-point shots. He's got a deuce. Ricky Brown, 2 of 3 from the field. Those were all threes. He's got 6 points. Paul King, 0 of 4 from the field, missed his only 3-point shot, and untarnished 2 of 2 from the free throw line for 2 points. He also has 5 assists. DJ Freeman, 5 of 7 from the field, 1 of 1 from downtown, 11 points. Of course, he's got those 3 fouls, as I mentioned earlier. Ethan Scott, 1 of 1 from the field. That was a big 3-pointer, as usual, 3 points. And then rounding out the scoring for the Bison, Trey Green, 2 of 3 from the floor, misses only 3-point shot, misses only free throw. He's got 4 points to round out the scoring for Oklahoma Baptist University. At halftime, Oklahoma Baptist leads Harding 43-37. Todd Miller will be back with play-by-play of the second half. This is Bison Basketball on Classic Hits KGFF. Okay.
Minutes away from coming to a conclusion at halftime, thanks to an 11-3 Harding run. The Bisons are within striking distance of Oklahoma Baptist, 43-37. Harding looking to end an 10-game losing skid. Let's take you around the conference to other action. All these games at halftime: East Central leading Southern Arkansas at the Kerr Center, 38-31. Northwestern 36, Henderson State 33. Wichita trailing at Southwestern at halftime, 32-30. It's Southern Nazarene down by 1 at halftime to Arkansas Tech, 24-23. Southeastern blowing out Arkansas Monticello and Durant, 47-26. Softball wins today, game 1 of 2 for them at Wichita Falls. They defeat Rockhurst, 3-0. Baseball trailing Missouri Western, 7-2. That game now in the top of the sixth inning. Into the first half, Harding shoots 44%, Oklahoma Baptist 54.5%. Bison win the battle of the boards 18-16, dead even at 7 of the offensive rebounds. Turnovers 5 for Harding, 4 for Oklahoma Baptist. Points off turnovers 7-2, OBU. Second chance points, Bison lead it 10-8 over Harding. Get at halftime, it's 43-37. Oklahoma Baptist on top of the Bisons from Searcy, Arkansas. Second half coming up next to the Bison Sports Network and Classic Hits, KGFF. Okay. Of over 450 Oklahoma Baptist University student athletes in the classroom, the communities, and their fields and courts of competition. When you give to the BAA, you are truly invested in champions. Learn more, sign up today at obubison.com/BAA. Also, don't forget to visit obubison.com to find more about Bison Backers Week that will include the Bison Backer Golf Tournament coming up in March at Fire Lake Golf Club here in Shawnee. And then, of course, the crown jewel, the Green and Gold Gala featuring Tim Tebow. OBUBison.com for more information. Pretty good start, Scott, in the first half for OBU, but an 11-3 finish by Harding has put them into a two-possession game, and OBU needs to quickly go out with the same intensity they started the ballgame with to begin the second half.
Like Coach Overton says, Harding's on scholarship too. But it's just unfortunate that the Bison didn't put them away, because struggling, like you mentioned, at home, better record on the road. Oklahoma Baptist could have put Harding and what down right there when they had them down 15, 14 points. They're up 6 now. They're fine. Just put the pedal to the metal, and the Bison get another big lead.
Taylor Curry went 1 for his first 6. He's starting to get more involved. He was 2 for 7 shooting the first half, and 4 of his 6 points did come from the free throw line. Harding was 4-4, Oklahoma Baptist 3-5 for the foul line. The Harding Bisons in the road black, gold, and white uniforms will have it, and they will move from left to right. Udomo fronts the entry pass. Curry rips it away from Akile. Right corner to Stetson Smithson. Back out front to McBride. OBU in a man-to-man defense. They bounce it down low for Curry. Backing down against Akile. Draws a double, hit the side of the backboard. Rebound to Paul King. Great defense by Bradley. King pulls up at the foul line. Jumper, no good. Rebound tipped by Smithson into the hands of Udomo. His scoop shot overshoots the entire rim of the rebound out of bounds to the far side. Possession to Harding.
Yeah, I don't know. King usually makes that. That was an easy shot at the bottom of the dotted line. Nobody in his face. He just bricked it. But great defense by Akili on Taylor Curry. Down there by the left block, hands straight up, forcing Curry to a brick off the side of the backboard.
Paul King did not start a point guard today. They played him off the ball. He does not have a Field goal, 2 points, but 4 rebounds, 5 assists. Smithson's 3 online and good. And it's a 3-point game at 43-40. Stetson Smithson had 10 rebounds, 2 points in the first game. He gets his first here of the second half and now has 7.
Yeah, that was a tough matchup. King on Smithson, who's 6'7".
King to the goal, to the trailer. Wilcox, who lays it in. How about his contortion going to the rim?
Yeah, leaning back. Spins it back over his head with the right hand. Beautiful reverse layup.
45-40 Oklahoma Baptist. A minute 10 into the second half. Smithson penetrates. Sets JT Smith up for 3, and he got it.
Those are open looks. No hands way up in the face on the last two shooters, Smith or Smithson.
7 of 15 shooting from 3 for Harding, 47%. They're a 30% three-point shooting team. Udomo with a 2-point game. Dan gets it around out front. Bounces for Wilcox. On the baseline, Neitzel with a jab step, fires a 15-footer, and it rattles home.
That's valuable for Oklahoma Baptist. You've got Freeman shooting outside and also Wilcox.
Through the paint goes Santiago, and it's spiked to the floor by Bradley Akile. The King bounces it up ahead for Brown. He'll catch, set for 3. Got it! Ricky Brown had all day long to trigger that 3, and OBU just like that has scored 5 in a row to take a 7-point lead.
Yeah, when I seen Brown gather himself and get those feet set, I knew it was over.
JT Smith through the key to the goal. Layup good. Five of the 8 for JT Smith here in the first, 2-10 of the second half. Harding will not go away. It's a 5-point Bison lead.
JT Smith saw a little bit of traffic up the middle. Just went to the right of it all the way to the rim.
Udomo skips right with a basketball to Akile out high, guarded by Stetson Smithson. Left side, Paul King working against McBride. Now it's Brown who bounces it in the low post for Wilcox. He puts Curry in a spin cycle going left to right and throws a one-hander in.
Welcome back, Nigel Wilcox. Unbelievable little fake spin pivot, high little baby hook.
Nigel Wilcox already with his first half output here in the first 3 minutes of the second half. He has 12. Curry, a hard dribble, leans in over Akile at back rims and goes down. Taylor Curry now with 10 points, 52-47 with under 17 to play in the ball game. Yeah. Udomo now will walk into the front court.
Harding scoring with no problems. OBU got to get some hands up, a little bit tougher defense other than Akile doing a good job down
Harding's
there.
Harding's hit 4 of 5 in the second half. They're up to 49% for the ball game. 9 to shoot. Paul King with it in front of his left wing. Gets a screen, now attacks, goes into Curry, bounces it across the floor. Akile's 3, rolls off. Curry with a rebound, and Nigel Wilcox knocked it out of bounds. Here comes DJ Freeman and Trey Green, both of whom have been starting as of late, both coming off the bench today. For Trey Green, it's only the 4th time he's been a reserve this year, and for DJ Freeman, the 3rd in now 21 games.
I don't know about bringing Freedom on the court when he's going on defense with those 3 fouls.
Good point. Smith into the paint, right quarter, jumper no good. That's McBride. Udomo posts the rebound out, then back tips it to Green. 2-on-1 to Josh. Play it good.
You knew it was over when you had 3-on-1 with Green with the ball.
Harding presses. Santiago at open 3. Back rims that one. McBride follows the shot. Dishes down low of the layup. Good that time by Taylor Curry.
Yeah, that's nothing the Bison could do on that. When you have that long 3 hit the neck and bounce out outside the 3-point line, it's hard to get that rebound.
Under 16 minutes to play. 54-49. OBU looking for a season sweep against the Bisons this year. Domo muscles up in the lane, comes up short. Smithson and Josh go to the floor as Smith pulls down the rebound and speeds ahead. Santiago to McBride, and he was standing on the sideline, so a missed opportunity there on turnover number 7 for Harding.
Maybe that's the break that Oklahoma Baptist needs, just that little not thinking turnover, and they can just get a big run here.
Timeout, 15:43 to play, second half, Oklahoma Baptist 54, Harding 49 to the Bison Network at KGFF.
Okay.
Spending wisely means taking small steps towards a life of love.
15:43 to play second half of the Noble Complex. We come to you from the Sawyer Center in Bethany, Southern Nazarene at Oklahoma Baptist. The rivalry renewed on Monday night, 5:30 for the women, and at 7:30 for the men. Both SNU teams comfortably atop the league standings. Our pregame show from Bethany at 5:04. Next week, it's UAM and Southern Arkansas on the road, and then a week from Thursday, the road odyssey concludes with a trip down to Durant. 2 weeks from today, East Central with the regular season finale here at home. Kings bounce pass, run down right wing side. Akile with it on the baseline, 15 to shoot. Ricky Brown to Paul King out front. King gets a screen, now is covered up by Smithson at the high post. Freeman drives and he was bumped by Curry, and that will be Taylor's first personal foul. You know, Curry is not only a good player, he's a smart player. I mean, he is very physical down low, very aggressive, but he didn't commit a lot of silly fouls.
Yeah, his hands are always straight up, and he uses that rule of verticality. It goes straight up. It's hard to move him out of the way.
15-19 to play second half. Crossover dribble. Akile, baseline jumper left, rolls around and drops in. 56-49, Oklahoma Baptist with an answer every time.
Yeah, that's big. That was a fortunate bounce for Akile.
McBride's three a little short. Almost came in off the top of the backboard, but Smithson is there for the follow. Stetson Smithson with nine. And again, Harding in a two-possession game, 56-51.
And when it took that extra bounce off the rim, it messed up DJ Freeman's timing where he was in the air and Smithson stayed down and he got the tip in.
King working right side against Keelan McBride. Akile inside the arc, fires a jumper, missed wide right. Keelan McBride, the freshman from Jonesboro, Arkansas, speeds down the middle of the floor. Underhands it to JT Smith, who funnels it to Curry for the two-handed flush.
See, a severely missed shot like that, that it causes numbers going the other way, and that really hurt Oklahoma Baptist.
56-53, the closest Harding has been since the opening couple of minutes of play of this ball game. Green gets a handoff, left baseline for King. He'll try to put up a three, it does! Boy, had just enough separation partner to get that shot up and over the defender and rattles it in for his first field goal.
You know, King's not scared of anything, you know. If there's a pressure shot, he wants to take it.
Remember that shot. It extends the lead back to six. Santiago drives, feeds to Curry. Layup good. Offensive foul. They'll take away the basket, and Santiago is going to be called for the charge.
Boy, that's huge because Santiago was just dumping that off for the automatic dunk to Curry. Big, big defensive play there.
JT Smith just picked up the foul. Out he comes, and Wyatt Gilbert comes in. Wilcox, Green, Paul King, Brown, and Freeman out there on the floor. That's primarily been the starting lineup as of late for Oklahoma Baptist since Nigel returned on Thursday night. Paul King left side. On the baseline is Ricky Brown. Bounces it to Nigel. Doubled now by Smithson and McBride. Out high, it's Brown. Bang! He knocks the eyes out of that one. Two big threes by Oklahoma Baptist, and they're in front by nine.
It was so dead center, the net barely moved. That's how accurate Brown is.
Santiago, a little flutter in the paint, gets two of them back. And right now, Harding is getting what they want near the rim and in the paint, Scott, because of the penetration.
Yeah, and you didn't need that on Santiago. Santiago's only made one three-pointer, and like I said, he only makes them from the corners. He's missing them. OBU played him, overplayed him out there on the perimeter, and he did the runner.
And Freeman has it poked away. Santiago with a steal to the goal, checks from behind, and then finger rolls it in. Santiago in double figures with 11. It's back to a five-point game. King and alley-oop up for Freeman for the slam. Holy Toledo, a terrific feed that time from King at the foul line.
Not only did King make a perfect pass, he got there fast in time, and he's looking at it. It doesn't look like he's going to pass it. He knows where he's going with that ball.
McBride for three, got it over Wilcox, right circle. Tell you what, if you're not concerned, you should be now because Harding's here to play. King down the paint to the goal, hit the side of the rim. Smithson with a rebound, had it poked free. Wilcox gets it. Jason Aker was trying to get a timeout called. The arrow favors OBU, so they'll have it with 20 on the shot clock.
I tell you, Curry used a hard knee right in the kidneys of Wilcox. He got away with a bad foul there.
Give Jeff Morgan and his kids from Searcy, Arkansas, a ton of credit. They've lost 10 straight. They're 1-15 in the conference. Haven't won since January the 7th, and they are giving OBU all they want and more as King off the dribble pulls up and rattles one in inside the arc out front. King has a 3, a 2, and an alley-oop lob in 3 of the last 4 possessions, and we get a timeout.
Yeah, give it up to Paul King. That's unbelievable. He went so fast. Freeman, he knows Freeman's the trailer. He gets to the left elbow. He's not even looking that direction. It looks like he's going to shoot it, and he just flicks it up there, and Freeman goes, gets it for the throwdown.
Timeout, 12:20 to play in the ballgame. Oklahoma Baptist 66, Harding 60 of the Bison Network and KGFF. Basketball, the Bisons are shooting 71% of the second half and 52% for the floor. OBU's gone to a zone. Gilbert handles it left quarter. Cross courts at Santiago's 3, front rims. Rebound tipped by Freeman away from Curry, and Brown has it. Ricky into the front court left. Now will slow it down. Paul King with the top of the circle, turns the corner to the goal. Hard bounce pass for Freeman and stolen away by McBride. Heads up play with the redshirt freshman. Into the paint he goes, glides and kicks right to Wyatt Gilbert. Down the paint to Smithson, his finger roll won't go. Tipped by Curry is offline. Green has it and speeds back the other way. Up ahead to Wilcox for the easy bucket.
Perfect pass by Green. Put it to the only place where Wilcox could catch it. It wasn't a dunk, but it doesn't matter. Went away from the defense to the right side of the rim. Easy layup.
OBU had 1 assist, 10 turnovers in the second half on Thursday as Curry gets a deflected pass and finishes off the glass. In this one, they have 18 assists on 29 made shots, 68-62, with 11-11 to play.
Well, when you got big men like Freeman and Wilcox that can run the floor, it makes it easier to get assists.
Paul King bounces it down low of the post. Freeman gets 3 defenders in the air and somehow left-handed kisses it in off the window.
And there's another assist. If I want to get an assist record, I just throw it to Wilcox and Freeman.
70-62. 10:54 to play, second half, along with Scott Wanish and Bob Easley. I'm Todd Miller on KGFF for the Bison Network. McBride dribbles between the legs. Wilcox pokes it out of his hands inside the lane. McBride gets it back, 12 to shoot. Wyatt Gilbert bounces to Smithson, drives left, layup good.
Good job by Smithson. He just bodied Brown down the left sideline. Brown's got to keep him out.
Fallaway jumper, Paul King, money right angle. Paul King igniting this second half effort for OBU. He has 9 points, 5 here in the second half.
He's going to get a double-double of points and assists.
72-64. King has 9 assists, 9 points. I think you're fair to say that. Santiago to McBride. Left side to Gilbert. Runs off the arc. Pulls up from 15. No good. Trey Green, weak side, uncontested for the board. Pulls the miss down and shoots it up ahead to Paul King. 10 minutes to play. 72-64. Oklahoma Baptist trying to get their 9th conference win of the year before they head on the road for 4 difficult games in Bethany, Monticello, Magnolia, and Durant. Freeman drives baseline, and he's hand-checked by Stetson Smithson, who has his 2nd. Smithson had not played very many games when these 2 teams played at Rhodes Reeves back in January. He looks more like his old self from last year. Told you the pregame show, I really like him. He has 11. If he only has a couple of the 5 baskets he has here today, Harding probably beats OBU.
Yeah, Smithson's got that good inside-outside game. He's 6'7". As we just witnessed, he bullied Ricky Brown all the way to the basket, just backed him in. And anytime Smithson wants to rise up, he can hit from downtown.
9:48 to play, back after this break. 72-64 OBU on KTFF. Throwing it underneath and out front, it goes to Akile, to Scott, now to King, follow-away jumper, in and out. Rebound tip, Paul King, had it go off of him out of bounds. He nearly knocked it off of Keelan McBride that time.
Here's an eight-point cushion that the Bison are holding on to. Big stop here.
OBU has made four of their last six from the floor. They're shooting almost 59% today. Davis Morgan, his final trip to Shawnee, holds high to McBride, to Santiago, down the paint, feeds it to Curry, one dribble, and he was going to posterize Akile, who blocked the shot, but they call the body foul. First on Josh, and Udomo has his second.
But that's important that Akile blocked that shot, because that would have been an and one if Akile doesn't come over and reject that dunk attempt.
72-64. Today has been kind of an exception to the rule when Paul King hasn't had 20 or more OBU scores well. That's what a healthy Nigel Wilcox will do for you, as the first Curry free throw is up and good. Although Paul has started to ignite him in the second half, he has five of his nine since the break. Working on a double-double, 9 points and nine assists. His four rebounds, one steal. He's played 22 minutes as Curry hits the second.
And those nine assists are gold for Paul King. Some of them were tough, dribbling through traffic right up the middle of the court.
How about this? OBU's hit four of their last five, not only from the floor, but from three-point range. Scott tries to add to that. Bang! He does a catch-and-shoot three for the left wing. Ethan with six.
And that's going to stretch the floor more, having Ethan Scott out there where Wilcox and Akile and Udomo can work inside.
I love that kid. He's a bulldog. 75-66 with under 9 minutes to play and a turnover as Davis Morgan has the ball slip through his fingertips out of bounds.
Well, it's forced by Paul King. Paul King tipped that and then went off the black shirt.
8:55 to play. Bison trying to hand Harding their 11th straight loss, but this has been a lot of their games this year. They've been competitive, just haven't been able to close. OBU so far has been able to answer the challenge time and time again. Udomo backs it out of the Bison center circle logo. Looks up, play clock halfway down. It's now at 13. Udomo, a high screen left from Wilcox. Attacks against Morgan. Fuddles it to Akile for the two-headed flush. Well, they are wearing out the rims on both ends of the floor with slams today.
Yeah, Udomo got by his man off the dribble. That pulled Curley away from Akile for the easy dunk.
40 of OBU's 77 points today inside the lane. Henderson with it right side. Cross courts. Morgan lobs it for Curry over the top. They got a mismatch with Scott. And then Wilcox is going to be called for the foul. That's his third. So DJ and Nigel each with three fouls for Oklahoma Baptist. That is only their second here with 8:11 to play. In fact, the whistle has not been blown much over the second half. Three against Harding and two against OBU.
I think Raymond Shipps called that on Wilcox because Curry, he followed through under the rim, creating that contact, making it look like a body block.
Taylor Curry does most of the free throw work for Harding on a nightly basis. He's the only Bisons to get there today, and he is now 8 of 8 as he hits both. Coming in, Harding averages 14 free throws a game. Taylor Curry now has 127 attempts to date. 8 minutes to play, 77-68 OBU. They head it back to 13, their biggest lead 16 of the first half. Udomo, left wing for Paul King. King hit a big three to spark this run. Now drop steps into the paint, missed it, follows his miss and tips it in.
Yeah, that's the second time Paul King has followed his shot. Other one was a three-pointer. That was in the trees with the tip in. Great play, Paul King.
Some people were born to score when they came into this world, and Paul King is one of those. Hand off left, Keelan McBride against Akile. Hard dribble right, loses it, ball on the floor. It's off Bradley out of bounds. Harding dodges a bullet with 14 to shoot and 7.5 to play. That'll take us to the under 8 media timeout. Oklahoma Baptist 79, Harding 68. We'll pause for these messages on the Bison Sports Network and Classic Hits, KGFF.
I'm Noble McIntyre, and I'm a trial lawyer. But that was not my original plan. I went to Oklahoma Baptist University and law school wasn't even on my radar. And then one day it was. Why? Sometimes those with more power than others abuse that power. Instead of doing the right thing because it's the right thing, they do the wrong thing because it's profitable. An innocent victim is victimized again. They feel helpless and voiceless against the multi-billion dollar insurance company. I saw it happen. I watched a family member suffer as the system left them feeling helpless and voiceless. I am not helpless, and I do have a voice. And for my clients, when the fight comes, The insurance company pulling strings in the shadows doesn't face a powerless victim. They face me. For way too long, insurance companies and major corporations have pushed around hardworking Oklahomans. McIntyre Law pushes back. If you need someone that tries cases and doesn't just settle, call McIntyre Law for a meeting at no cost to you. We are McIntyre Law.
Lunch specials between 11 and 2, Monday through Friday, $5.49. A student special that includes a large one-topping pizza and cheesy bread for only $10. Pizza lovers get it with Marco's Pizza. Santiago triggers it inbound to Keelan McBride. Now to Henderson out front to Santiago to Curry, and he spins away and slams it home.
Great call by Jeff Morgan out of the break. Akili got behind Curry on that rotation.
79-70. Harding hanging around with just over 7 minutes to play. Udomo with it to the front court left. Guarded by Sam Henderson. Now drives around McBride. Leans in and a foul against Taylor Curry. That's his second, and Udomo will have to earn him for the free throw line. This will only be the sixth and seventh free throws attempted today by Oklahoma Baptist. They did not have many attempts in the first meeting. They were just 8 of 8 at the free throw line at Searcy. First foul shot by Udomo is no good. Josh in that game played 15 minutes at Rhodes Reeve and had 4 points. He had 5 points, a steal, 2 assists here on Thursday night in the loss to Arkansas Tech. Bison trying to head out of the road for 4 difficult games above 500. Udomo's second free throw, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Stetson Smithson. Lead remains 9 with 7 to play. Henderson with it, left wing side of the Harding forecourt. Curry, guarded by DJ Freeman, whips it across the floor. They'll step into a 3 with Santiago, and he splashes it home.
Nice shot by Santiago because Wilcox is closing in. Anytime you see a shot blocker like him, it's got to make you think twice.
Harding within 6. They're on a 5-0 run over the last minute of the ball game. Udomo doing a lot of dribbling against Keelan McBride out front. Left quarter it goes for Wilcox. Back to King, right side to Akile to Paul. He'll put up an NBA 3. Got it! Paul King with money and ice in his veins. 82-73, good Bison.
Boy, that's a big shot. He was determined to shoot it about 3 feet behind the line. The defender is sagging back a little bit. He goes, I better get out there, but not too late.
McBride, a behind-the-back dribble, cut off at the high post. Santiago drives baseline and throws in a one-hander. This guy can really score today, he has. Anyway, 16, he averages under 9. And he only had 8 in the game at Rhodes Reeves back in January. Incidentally, for our Harding listeners, my favorite road venue of the conference. Freeman with it out high, angles left, goes into the body of Curry, tries to get him into the spin cycle, he banks it up and in anyway. Curry just did nothing but stand vertical, and Freeman still got the trajectory to kiss it in.
Well, I think Curry jumped a little bit, 6'11 in that long reach, just barely got over the fingertips.
17 points now for Freeman. Smithson gets a cross-court pass, drives to the rack, draws the foul. There was a collision, and Stetson will go to the free throw line after Bradley Akile picks up his second.
Stetson Smithson is going to get these 2 shots, but before that, Harding missed a golden opportunity because Wilcox and Freeman came out to double, and standing under the goal wide open was Curry.
Smithson with 11 points, make it 12 as he splashes home the first free throw. Green and Ricky Brown will come in. Brown, we told you, injured his ankle this morning. He's played 21 minutes and really been effective. 4 of 5 shooting all from 3, a rebound and 1 assist. And the Stetson Smithson second free throw finds the bottom of the can, crawled across the front of the rim. 84-77 Oklahoma Baptist with 5:24 to play. Buckle up, folks. Another tight one of the league this afternoon from shot 8. Paul King from the right to left flank. Between the circles, it's Freeman to Brown. Guarded by Santiago, gives up some inches there. Trey Green, left wing, trying to penetrate the zone to Brown for another 3 at front rims, and Smithson boxes out Trey Green for the rebound. McBride angles into the front court, gets it on a return pass from Santiago, right flank. Now he cross-courts it to Henderson, who drives. Sam funnels it to Curry, who spins, goes up in front of the rim, and drops it home.
Now, Curry was in the middle of the lane when that ball was on the right side of the floor. So it was about 5 or 6 seconds. Now you're in a battle here with crunch time because OBU didn't put the Harding Bisons away in the first half.
Taylor Curry started the day 1 for 6. He's now 7 for his last 7, and he has a team in game high 24. 4.5 minutes to play. Wilcox comes to a jump stop of the high post. Bounces right side for King. Looks up at the shot clock at 70. Jab steps, now drives, fall away 15-footer, in and out. Rebound to Trey Green. And they play on despite the shot clock buzzer going off. Nigel Wilcox back to Trey Green out front. It's currently at 14. King around Henderson, cut off by Curry. Now he'll fire a 16-footer and it's blocked. Smithson with a rebound, goes back against Green and loses it out of bounds. And that was all because of Trey Green.
Trey Green, great job hustling back. Paul King ill-advised trying to shoot that over 6'11" Curry. He knew it. He hesitated at first, and then Curry got that block.
He is grumbling as he walks by us back to the bench. Ethan Scott comes in. Trey Green took the contact, and it turned out to be turnover number 10 for the Bisons. This game has been well played. Only 16 turnovers between these two rivals. 3:45 to play. Ethan Scott with it out front in the left flank. Got it by Sam Henderson. Whips it across the floor. McBride ducks into the backcourt. Keithan with a steal, one-on-one of the goal. Misses everything. Henderson comes down with a rebound, and it's off of Sam out of bounds.
Well, that's two plays going the other way that Oklahoma Baptist got bailed out on.
You're right. Timeout, 3:39 to play, second half. Bison lead is just 5. 84-79 to the Bison Sports Network and KGFF. Play 84-79, and Scott, OBU shooting almost 60% for the ball game. They're 62% here in the second half, but if I would have told you before the game they shoot 58 plus with 3.5 to go, you think this is probably a rout, but it's not, because 67% Harding field goal shooting in the second half and 54% for the day.
There were a couple opportunities OBU could have put this game away. They're up 14-15 right in that area. And they didn't do it, and that's what happens now. Now you're in this dogfight for the last 3:30.
Something you repeatedly talked about in the first half. Ethan Scott, right front court to Trey Green. Shot clock at 16. Ricky Brown with those pink shoes kicks it to Wilcox against the zone. They're working the perimeter. Ethan Scott, three dribbles, moves right, bounces it down low. Nigel with six to shoot, squares up against Curry. Drives around Taylor, lays it in! Oh, my goodness, and he's back to the basket. He flipped it up over his head and kissed it off the window.
That's the only way he could score over the 6'11 Curry. He crossed the lane from right to left, reverse layup, and reached as far as he could.
86-79, 2:55 to play. Santiago to Curry, head of the circle, drives against Freeman, spins right, missed it short. Freeman battling for the rebound, saves it to Santiago, who feeds it to Smithson for the lay-in. Boy, Harding just will not go away. It's a five-point game again, 86-81 with 2:45 to play.
Yeah, they're crashing. They're getting it to Curry. Curry's going hard. Then you got 6'7" Stetson Smithson that's just crashing the boards every time.
Two of the worst rebounding teams in the conference by per-game margin, and it's a one-point advantage of the glass for OBU, 28-27, including plus one on the offensive end. Wilcox, high post right against Curry. He's going to take him off the dribble. Goes hard to the rim. Curry knocked it away. Wilcox gets it back to Ethan Scott for three. That one is no good. Curry down for the rebound. Wilcox is going to commit his fourth as he was trying to get him tied up.
Boy, I like Wilcox being aggressive going after that, but Curry had that ball secured under his chin, and he reached in. Good call by KC LA.
I'm sorry, Scott.
It's just you don't know if you want Wilcox to have four fouls. You know, Freeman's got three, so if this goes overtime, that could be a big foul.
86-81 with 2 minutes to play. Keelan McBride. Fine, a three over Nigel. Bang! He got it well beyond the arc. What a gutsy shot by the redshirt freshman. 86-84. The pressure swings back to OBU. Brown into the right front court. How many leagues 1-15 team could come in and play a talented club, the preseason number three pick of the conference, and have a shot to win in mid-February? It tells you how deep and how good this league is. Green whips it across the floor. It's stolen by McBride. Saves it to Henderson. Sam starts the alternate break. Feeds it to Smithson. He attacks right. Kicks it to Henderson. Returns to the three. Throws up a floater, and it banks in and out. Spun out of the circumference of the hoop, and then a foul. Sam Henderson trying to knock the ball off Freeman is called for a foul. It's his first.
Boy, Sam Henderson almost got a technical from Casey Ellie. Said all ball, no way, was screaming the whole time. The reason why Henderson missed that initial shot is because it was challenged so high by Wilcox it barely bounced out.
Yeah, and he had a remarkable shot to get it off, and it went around and around and then fell out. OBU by two, 77 seconds to play. Already this Harding team has won at Southeastern. That's been their only conference win. Paul King to Green out front. Left corner, Ricky Brown for three. Airballs it. Green battles with Smithson, and Stetson came down out of bounds. And Stetson Smithson, if you're watching and listening, pleading for a push on Trey Green.
I don't think Green pushed him out. I mean, they're both going for the ball. It looked like Green was pretty vertical. I mean, it's a debatable play.
How about timeout for a Jason Aker special in the inbounds? 103 to play, 86-84 Oklahoma Baptist on the Bison Sports Network at KGFF. Actually, let's make it just a 30. They cut it short on me. Just a 30. First United Bank, educating and empowering our community to spend life wisely with convenient locations in Shawnee and nearby Seminole. First United Bank is the official bank sponsor of OBU Athletics. I thought it was going to be a 60. It was a 30. 103 to play. Oklahoma Baptist in a one-possession, two-point game. Harding looking to end a 10-game losing streak. This would be a killer for OBU if they can't close it out. Green to inbound underneath. Gets it right corner for Paul King. King with seven to shoot to the foul line. Bounces for Wilcox. For the two-handed flush. And he's fouled by Santiago.
You call it Jason Aker special out of bounds in that line formation. There's so many options that the Bison can do. Curry messed up the first option, getting in the middle, forcing Wilcox out. Then King gets the ball. He's such a strong dribbler. Bounces perfect, tiny window to Wilcox for the two-handed slam.
88-84. Jason Aker brought all five Bison over in front of us, and Jeff Morgan for the other end wants a timeout. 57 seconds to play. 88-84. The Bison Network and Classic Hits, KGFF. Seconds to play. OBU can make it a five-point game with a end one from Nigel Wilcox after Ramiro Santiago committed the foul on what was a perfectly executed inbound pass designed by Jason Aker. It all started with a pass from out high for Paul King. Wilcox slammed it home, and Santiago tried to challenge and committed the foul. This is what I talk about. Not that Harding doesn't know how to win. That's what I said. I meant more like they have forgotten how to win. This game has been there for the taking, and it still is, with just under a minute to play.
Well, I tell you, they're fighting tooth and nail.
Yes, they are.
Took everything for Wilcox. Wilcox was covered really close, like you say, by Santiago, and he still rises up while getting contact with the two-handed flush.
Nigel's free throws. The place goes quiet. Is on the way, and it's good. This guy has been money today. 19 for Nigel Wilcox. 54 seconds to play. Santiago to the front court. Bites it by five. Romero kicks it left side. McBride off the dribble. A three. Got it! Holy cow! McBride with his 6-3 of the ball game and a timeout. With 44 seconds to play, it's 89-87. Yes. Now Casey Ely is coming over to the monitor, and I think they may check to make sure it was a three and not a two.
Yeah, I think it was, but a three. That ball, that was shot just over the left-hand fingertip of DJ Freeman and still was nothing but net.
Here is the game reset as they look next door at the monitor to check the shot for two or three. And it was indeed as a three-point play. From our angle, it looked like he was clearly behind the line, but you had the opportunity to check that, and why not in a two-point game? Possession arrow favors Harding. One timeout for OBU, two for the Bisons. Sam Henderson will use a little bit of pressure in the backcourt. And here we go. They'll inbound to Paul King. A difference of 16 of the shot and game clock. Jason Aker with his hands folded directly in front of us. King on the Bison center circle loco. Harding in a man-to-man defense. Cross court it to Ricky Brown. Back to Paul King with 12 to shoot. King to Trey Green. One dribble back to Paul. Paul, fall away jumper, elbow right, no good. Trey Green with a rebound, dribbles out from underneath. And a foul by Harding.
Wow, the IQ of Trey Green just being in the right spot. He might have got a fortuitous bounce there, but he's underneath the right block in perfect rebounding position at the right time to pick up that bad miss on the right side.
Taylor Curry with his third, the seventh against Harding. It'll be a 1-1, and Jeff Morgan, the equivalent of freezing the kicker in football, is going to call a timeout. We're going to keep it right here with 18.3 seconds to play at Oklahoma Baptist leading 89-87. Update from Arkadelphia, Missouri Western leading to the top of the eighth with the Bison batting 7-3 in baseball. Softball beat Rockhurst earlier today in Wichita Falls, Texas 3-0. OBU in softball is a blown lead away from a 7-0 start. They allowed just one run in five games last weekend in Louisiana. Led 6-0 over Fort Hays State yesterday in the fifth and lost 7-6.
Wow.
Bounce back today with a 3-0 win. Boy, if I had fingernails, I'd be chewing them right now.
But just great execution by Oklahoma Baptist. They execute all those plays, like the inbound play, the rebound, just great plays here.
Trey Green's first free throw is up and good. That's a three-point lead, and he'll try to make it four. This is 101st game on Bison Hill. One of the greatest players of the Division II era here at Oklahoma Baptist. Second one good. How about that? That's as clutch as it gets. 91-87, 18 seconds to play. McBride has kept him close. Handles it on the bounce pass and the inbounds pass. 15 seconds to play. McBride throws it away. He was looking for Stetson Smith, and Santiago could not get there.
That's why I love that pressure so much. It makes that other team play so much faster than those long skip passes are low percentage.
Green will inbound to King. Santiago a quick foul with 11.8 seconds to play. Ramiro with his third foul, and King will go to the line to make this a full two-possession game with 11.8 seconds to play. Trey Green, Ricky Brown, Nigel Wilcox, DJ Freeman, all huddling around Jason Aker in front of us. Jason, the sixth all-time winning coach at Oklahoma Baptist, looking for career win number 85. King's free throw is up and good. Paul King with 15 points. He has 11 of those here in the second half. Chance to make it 16, and that one is good. 93-87, 10 seconds to play. Keelan McBride in the front court, left of the Curry screen. McBride picks his dribble up, 5 seconds to play. Santiago's pass knocked away. McBride gets it back to Ramiro. He'll fire a three. It's no good. Bison win. 93-87, the final score. Oklahoma Baptist has beaten Harding this afternoon here at the Noble Complex. Jeff Morgan's team suffers their 11th consecutive defeat but it didn't come without some big-time heroics by Oklahoma Baptist Bison in the second half.
It took flawless execution for Oklahoma Baptist University to hold off Harding. The free throws at the end were clutch for Trey Green, Paul King. The rebound by Trey Green on the offensive end. They're only up a bucket, gets the offensive rebound in the right position. Percentages are going to go your way. It bounces off the right side of the rim. Green gets it. That inbound play was just impeccable. A tiny passing lane for King to Wilcox. Wilcox has the defender close to his body. He still has the legs to get up and dunk while getting hit.
Final score, Oklahoma Baptist 93, Harding 87. We'll begin our post-game show with player and coach interviews and final stats after this message on the Bison Network and KGFF. Okay. Hi, my man.
We gotta talk about you and not like the LeBron.
Huh? Todd Miller, Scott Wunsch back here with you, courtside of the Noble, where Oklahoma Baptist splits their penultimate home game of the season, winning 93-87 over Harding, and give the Bisons a ton of credit because they came in with nothing more to play than for pride at 1-15 of the conference, losers of 10 straight, and they had this thing down to a one-possession game, Scott. It all started with a big three from Paul King. King did hit a two. He had an assist. There were a couple of and-ones that were very beneficial for OBU, and then of course the late rebound off the initial Paul King miss by Trey Green turned those into two free throws on the back ends of a 1-1, and the Bison good enough to escape today, 93-87.
Well, welcome back, Nigel Wilcox. 10 of 11 from the floor. That kind of shooting, I know those are close range shots overall, but 10 of 11, the big dunk, 21 points, 5 rebounds, and a block shot. It seems like nothing's wrong with Nigel Wilcox's ankle.
93-87, the final score. Bison led it by 6 at halftime. Each team with 50 in the second half. And doesn't matter if you win by 1 or 40, it's still a win. And OBU moves the game above 500 of the conference at 9-8 before heading out now for 4 consecutive road games. Both teams shot extraordinarily well today. Oklahoma Baptist 56%, 38 of 68. OBU was 9 of 21 from 3 for 43%. Harding finishes at 53% for the game, 33 of 62, 11 of 24 from three-point range. And in the second half, the Bisons were 63%, Oklahoma Baptist 57%. Rebounds today, OBU plus 4, 32 to 28, 14 to 10. Oklahoma Baptist to the offensive glass, 11 turnovers for Harding, 8 for OBU, 16 assists for the Bisons, 33 made baskets, Oklahoma Baptist, 23 assists on 38 made field goals. 6 steals for Harding, 3 for OBU, each team with 1 block in the ballgame. Points from turnovers, 19-14 OBU. Points of the paint, 46-44 Bison. Second chance points, OBU 19-14. Fast break points, 19-2. Bench scoring today, how about this, 29-0. Harding did not get a point from the reserves, and they fall today, 93-87. Officially today, five Oklahoma Baptist players in double figures. Bradley Akile, one of those, with 11 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists. Bradley making the start today, his 10th as a Bison here on OBU's campus. And we'll hear from Bradley with Scott next as the postgame show continues on the Bison Sports Network and Classic Hits, KGFF. Good job, Bradley. Heck of a game. Sit down here. This chair.
How you do this?
Yeah, move it out just a little bit right here.
Oh, okay, okay. Appreciate it.
About a minute and a half commercial.
Welcome back to Bison Hill. Bison win 93-87 with five players in double figures. One of those guys, 6'7", Bradley Akile,
yes,
out of Houston. Need your big body today against 6'11", Taylor Curry. You got 6'7", Stetson Smithson. Mm-hmm. They really go to the rim hard. They're going to fight you tooth and nail for every rebound.
Yes, sir.
We needed you there today.
Yes, sir.
So what was your contribution?
I feel like just rebounding early in the game and bringing energy to the team early on in the game, and everybody fed off that.
Yeah, you had 3 rebounds, 2 on the offensive end, 5 of 10 from the field, 11 points. But there are some big plays down there on defense that you're picking up. You got the toughness. You're going against those guys. They're banging you, but you're not backing down from nobody.
Yes, sir.
So what's your mental attitude there about that toughness to go against these guys?
I mean, I just take it one play at a time and focus on the play that's happening currently in the moment and then go on from there.
How about your teammate Nigel Wilcox? 10 of 11 from the field, tough rebounds. He's got a block shot, tough inside. Makes it easier on you and DJ Freeman as the big guys to get that extra big in there. Mm-hmm. Welcome back, Nigel.
Yes, sir. That's tough for him coming back. What, his second game back? He already got what? What do you have?
21 points.
21 points, 4 or 5 rebounds. That's tough. We needed that.
Yeah, it's almost like he didn't miss a step.
Yeah. And he got the last dunk there for Paul's 10th assist. Paul had a double-double, too. A lot of people was in double digits today.
Bradley Akile reading the stat sheet. He knows it all about it. That was a huge play. What did Jason Aker call on that inbounds play on that dunk?
I'm not sure, but Paul got it in the lane. Late in the clock, got him the dime under the rim. Nigel caught it with 2 hands and dunked it for the N1 to seal the deal.
It was a narrow passing lane for Paul. Like you said, he had double-digit assists, 10 assists, 16 points, and then a narrow window for Nigel Wilcox just to get that dunk off in the trees there.
Hey, man, he got it done. That's all that matters.
All right, so what do you guys got to do to win Monday at Southern Nazarene?
do the same thing. We got to be tough on the inside because they're big on the inside too. But we have Nigel back, so it's going to be a little bit easier on me and DJ. But just be tough the whole game and take it one play at a time.
Congratulations, Bradley.
Thank you.
Bradley Akile, 5 of 10 from the field. He had 11 points, 3 assists in this game, coming up big, helping out the bigs with DJ Freeman, Nigel Wilcox, Bradley Akile, basically the tallest guys on the field. Legend Barrett, he played just a minute 20. Oklahoma Baptist defeats Harding 93-87. Todd Miller will be back to interview head coach Jason Aker after this. This is Bison Basketball on Classic Hits KGFF. Thank you.
Okay, guys, we gotta make this quick. I got a 7 o'clock curtain call at the opera.
You know you could just order online.
Has joined us, and Coach, I love the way your guys came out with a hunger, a renewed spirit today after a tough game on Thursday, and you needed that good start because you knew Harding was not going to go away, and they really, really stretched you and pushed you to the limit today.
I tell you what, we could never get a gap on them. Thank goodness for... That was by far our best offensive game. 23 assists and 8 turnovers. We needed every last single one of those points because every time we scored, I felt like they scored almost every time in the second half. I mean, we tried several different defenses. They're really hard to guard with their big man and their schemes, and then they started skipping it and getting us from rotation. So I thought our guys were trying really hard. It wasn't a matter of effort on defense. I think it was a matter of how well Harding, both teams, I thought, did a really, really good job on offense. I felt like both teams were trying really hard on defense, but neither team could stop. We told our guys earlier today is that anytime we've out-rebounded a team, we've won, and I just looked at it, and we won by
four.
And so that timely offensive rebound by number 20, Trey Green, those clutch free throws, and then Nigel made a couple amazing defensive plays late. And then Paul King had, I thought he was a point guard, a floor general, and that was a great pass. I think it was to DJ late, or maybe it was to Nigel.
Nigel, and he got the N1.
So.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about.
I'm proud of the fact that we won.
Yeah.
That's one of the first times we've won at home all year.
I was going to ask you about Paul King today because you and I had talked about in your office. You're kind of in between with him. You want his scoring, but you also want him to be a little bit more of a floor general, and I thought he really combined both today. The three-point basket he hit here on the left wing side that made it a two-possession game after Harding had got it down to two. Then he has the nice assist you're talking about to Nigel. He has another basket. I thought he was really good, but maybe the play of the game was from number 20, Trey Green, that offensive rebound that gave you a little bit of breathing room when he hit both ends of the one-and-one.
There's a lot of plays out there. I thought within the last 4 to 8 minutes, I thought there were several possessions we played really good defense. Like that kid rose up over, we put Nigel on him. He rose up over Nigel a few times, and then when they were touching the paint, and then when they get it inside, man, they were really hard to guard. What in the second half, they shot
63%.
63%, 54 from three, and 100% from the free throw line. I felt like they scored every time. And so the real reason why we won, do you want to know the real reason why we won?
I'm going to let you tell me.
So the two reasons why we won, Gene Hacker, who was a junior on the basketball team. My dad was here as a freshman. One of his best friends was here today. And then the real, real reason why we won today is because Harrison Stoddart and Caleb Norris were here. And so we needed all three of those Bison basketball, just awesome former guys. And so we have so many former players, but it was really neat to give Gene Hacker a hug after the game with Mr. Parrish. And then run up there and see Harrison and Caleb. Man, I miss seeing Harrison every day. He's such a special young man. But we got number 20. We got on Trey Green this year, and he was clutch tonight.
All right, last question. You head out of the road for four straight. A, it was nice to see these guys smile again after a game, and it was certainly a shot in the arm you need with the schedule you have coming up.
Yeah, they weren't real happy with me the last 24 hours, but, you know, we're going through that process of it's not necessarily I'm going to tell you what you want to hear. My job is to tell you with love what you need to hear. And so for us to be a winning team, we have to keep improving. I felt like we improved the last 2 days. I felt like we've been improving and even in some of the losses. But I need to keep giving them the truth. But there's that delicate balance of challenge and support. And so you're always walking a tightrope as a coach in February of how much challenge, how much support. But I'm really thankful for the win. And I felt like both teams were deserving of winning, but I felt like our guys were deserving of winning. And it sure was nice to have Nigel down there on defense late in the game when you needed to stop. He's definitely someone that's used to getting stops and winning games late.
Coach, appreciate it. Congratulations on the win. We'll see you on Monday, but between now and then, big game, Super Bowl Sunday. You can get your rack of ribs for tomorrow.
The Super Bowl's tomorrow?
Yeah.
Who's playing?
I think the Eagles and somebody told me the Chiefs.
Mahomes versus who's the quarterback of the
Jalen
other one?
Jalen Hurts.
Oh, Jalen from OU.
Yeah.
So Hurts versus Mahomes.
Yeah.
I'm rooting for my mom really likes Mahomes, so I'm rooting for him. But we'll be over at we'll be here for film, and then we'll be over at Snoo Praxa tomorrow night. So we don't really get caught up in a whole lot of football. So we'll got a big game on Monday against the best team in our league in their court. They've been dominant on their court, and they were dominant against us on our court. So we got our hands full to get ready to give our guys a game plan to get ready for Monday night.
So really no rack of ribs after church?
No, I might afterwards if I take my own car over there. Oklahoma City, I definitely might sneak by Charleston's on the way home.
I thought so. Good to see you, Coach.
All right, Todd.
Jason Aker visiting with us. His team wins 93-87. The final numbers. We'll check the individual stats after these messages on the Bison Sports Network and KGFF. This is it. Cox with a season-high 21 points, 5 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal, 1 block shot effort. Also in twin figures, DJ Freeman with 17 of 4 rebounds. He had a steal. 16 points from Paul King, 11 of those in the second half. He had a big 3, a big 2, had a big assist, and really, really was instrumental with OBU escaping Harding. Also in twin figures today, 11 points, 1 rebound from Ricky Brown. He had 1 assist, 11 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists for Bradley Akile. You heard from him earlier with the postgame show. 6 points from Ethan Scott. It was 2 of 3 from 3-point range. All of those were needed. Trey Green with 6 points, including 2 big free throws late to help seal the deal for Oklahoma Baptist, and 4 points from Josh Udomo, who pulled down 4 rebounds and had 2 assists. OBU had just 1 block shot today, and that was, guess who? Nigel Wilcox. 24 apiece from Taylor Curry and Keelan McBride in a losing effort today for Harding. 16 points for Ramiro Santiago and 15 points from Stetson Smithson. And the only other Harding Bisons to score was JT Smith with 8, 2 rebounds, 2 assists for JT Smith. In the rebound department, they had co-leaders in Smithson and Curry, each with 7 boards. In the assist department, Harding was led by Santiago's 5 assists. 3 steals today from Keelan McBride, the 1 block again for Taylor Curry. All is well in Bison land as far as the men are concerned. Not so well for the women, who went to 3-8 in their last 11. And it gets no easier. They go on the road for 4 straight, starting at Southern Nazarene on Monday night. And I'm going to tell you right now, as far as the men are concerned, don't be surprised if Southern Nazarene didn't win the whole thing this year. I just think they are so good defensively right now. At last check, with 3 minutes to go, they had held Arkansas Tech to 43 points. Well, 37 minutes into the ballgame. That's phenomenal defense.
It is phenomenal defense. And Adam Bohaj, what he does, those guys, they close down the passing lane so well. They're so long, but there's no way that they hold Oklahoma Baptist to 43 points. But here's the thing. Jason Aker, when he walked off the set with you, he goes, hey, we just couldn't stop him. I said, it doesn't matter. They can stop you either at this juncture. You know, a win's a win, and that's what he says. So that's at the same time. So you've got a chance at Southern Nazarene. You can outscore them because Oklahoma Baptist with Nigel Wilcox has upped its game a little bit. Wilcox, 10 of 11 from the field, as you mentioned, 21 points. 10 of 11, that is huge. You shoot 56% from the field. Great win for the Bison.
Bison women lose earlier today. Let's take you around the Great American Conference. At last check, 3:47 left in Ada. East Central leading Southern Arkansas 74-66. They are in overtime at last check at Alva. Henderson State, Northwestern tied at 76. Southwestern holds off Ouachita 69-68 today in Weatherford. With 3:15 left, Arkansas Tech trailing 55-43 in Methody. And Southeastern today has beaten Arkansas Monticello 89-60. Here are men's final, Oklahoma Baptist 93 and Harding 87. Hope you'll join us coming up on Monday night for Rivalry Night, part 2 of the Great American Conference. It's Oklahoma Baptist at Southern Nazarene. Women at 5:30, the men at 7:30. We'll begin with our pregame show on KGFF, 100.9 FM, AM 1450 in Shawnee on the Bison Network at 5:04. For Scott Wattish and for Bob Easley, for the final time for the Noble Complex, until a couple of weeks, I'm Todd Miller. So long, everybody.